If you enjoy building interfaces in Airtable, you are going to love the fact that the Airtable interface buttons just keep getting smarter. In this video, I'm going to break down all the new features that have been released with the interface buttons. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you save 20 hours of your time every week using no-code tools. I know that's a big promise, but the cornerstone of saving time and getting organized in no-code is the power of automation. If you haven't already started leveraging no-code automation in your business, you are going to love the free training I've put together. You can get that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and there you're going to get all the fundamentals of building in no-code automation. Check that training out so that you can start reclaiming your time and start to automate the bullshit. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this video. We've got to talk about how the new interface buttons are just unlocking even more potential for us inside of Airtable. So really quick, we gotta jump into my data schema first. I've kept it really simple here so that we can build some really cool buttons in an interface or two. So first in our data schema, we've got projects and tasks. These are two different tables. And of course, tasks are going to relate to projects. So I've got three different projects and I have a status field here. We're gonna track a project through its life cycle. It's gonna start as a lead, then hopefully we onboard them as a client. Then at some point, we're going to assign assets to that particular project. Then the project is in progress. And then once it's completed, then of course we move it to the complete phase or status. So the idea here is that when we get into the assigning phase, that's when we want to go in and push a button and automatically create some tasks for that project. Flipping on into the tasks table then, we just have a simple task table that has a name of a task, who it's assigned to, and what project it belongs to. I'll go ahead and group by this project so that we can see all the tasks related to a project here. And one other thing that we generally like to have in a tasks table is some sort of checkbox to determine if it is complete or incomplete. And of course, also for tasks, you almost always want to have a due date of sorts. And we'll go ahead and display the time zone here as well. Generally, time doesn't matter all that much for due dates, so I'll keep that toggled off and we'll create this field. So the idea here being that, hey, here are some tasks that are coming due in the next week, and I can see them here. So that as I log in, I get to see those tasks that are assigned to me, when they're due, and what is still outstanding, what hasn't been completed yet. So now let's go ahead and hop into my interface designer. You'll see that I've already started some high-level different interface pages here. The first one is to assign tasks, and you'll notice that I've stipulated that these are in the status of assigning. And so the idea here is that only when a project is in the assigning status, then we want it to show up in this interface so that we can start assigning some tasks to the project. And then below that, you'll see my second page where I have track assigned projects. So the idea here is that only those projects that have been assigned to someone and have tasks related to them are going to show up here. So let's go ahead and take these one at a time. Let's pop into the first one, the assign tasks interface. Inside of here, all I have is a record picker at this point. I haven't included any of the other magic just yet. So coming down to add element in the bottom left corner of our screen, we can then choose all elements. And if we scroll on down to the bottom here, we can pick the button element. Drop this in anywhere and we'll go ahead and resize it. Now you may notice that this has changed ever so slightly. And if we look at the top of this element, we see that there is now a field status of the element called button type. And this is where we can choose what we want this particular button to do. So check this out. These are some options that we haven't had in the past. Delete the record with a push of a button, meaning that I'm already here inside of project 2, and I could assign the function of this button to simply delete the record with simple click. That is pretty cool. I also have the ability to flip through other records here so I can go to the previous or next record. I can drive to a specific interface page. I can drive to an external URL or go to the URL in the record. So if there's a URL being stored in the record, presumably this action would take us there. But the most exciting part of all of these for me is the new ability to run an automation. So we can actually control an automation directly from the interface. Now this is brand new because previously we had to take an action of updating the record to something very specific in order to then watch for that update in order to trigger an automation. And so it was a bit of a janky workaround that we now no longer need to worry about. So let's go ahead and run an automation. We will simply say, hey, we're going to build an automation that will assign tasks for this project when it's pushed. We can change the color of this and, of course, change this text to say something like assign tasks. Now we can go into the automation side of things, flip into our automations, and we can build a simple automation. When we click on see all in the trigger of the automation, we can scroll down and we find when a button is clicked. Again, this has to be a button in the interface as far as I understand. We've tested this so far with a button inside of the database itself, and it doesn't have the same functionality. So again, this is an interface button inside of an Airtable interface. So now we can simply say, yes, when a button is clicked. Let's go ahead and give a quick name to this automation. We'll call this assign tasks, just so that we're keeping everything labeled appropriately. And now we'll work to set up the automation with the button itself. You'll see here that we've got the configuration set up. It asks us to open the interface, which we already have open, create or select a button, then select trigger an automation and choose this automation from the list. Since we've now named this automation assign tasks, this should be pretty easy. Let's flip back into our interface now, and we can choose an automation from the button element that we've just created. And now we see that new automation that we've built. Now you will notice that our automation is not deployed. We haven't yet turned it on, so this button remains grayed out. So let's go ahead and finish up the idea behind our automation. Flip back into the automation. We can now choose a record here. Any of these records will do for the purpose of this automation. Remember, this was supposed to be a project that was in the status of assigning. So we're going to add an action and I will create a record. I will create a record in my tasks table because I want to create tasks for this particular project. And we're going to name it task one. I will also include who it's assigned to. In this case, I'm the only person on this particular database. And the due date, I'll just hard code or make up a date for now. I'll make it 8/25. You could, of course, make this date somewhat dynamic if you had some formulas inside of your project that were taking your start date and adding a certain number of days out. You could make this more dynamic, but for the purpose of this video, I'm plugging in a static due date to keep things rolling. So we've created now our first task, and we can replicate this multiple times. Again, in the interest of time, I will only create the one task. But then let's make sure that we also update this to link it to the project that pushed the button. To do this, we just choose another field and we make sure that we include the link to projects. And the project record ID would be identified in the trigger of this automation. So right here, we're looking at the first step of the automation when the button was clicked. And so we are taking the dynamic record ID. Dynamic because it will change every time a button is clicked, depending on what record we were looking at in the project's table. That will then be assigned to this task, so we'll have created a task for that project. Now we can add one further action where we're going to actually take the project out of the assigning status because now it's been assigned. We gave it a task, so we can move it out of there and put it in the in progress status. So in order to do this, we will click on update a record. Of course, the record we're updating is the project record here. So again, we need to go into the trigger when the button is clicked was our trigger here. We plug in our record ID and we're going to update the status field to match in progress. So we're moving it out of the assigning status into in progress. So let's just really quickly turn our automation on, flip back into our interface now, and let's publish this and give it a test. Publishing changes have taken effect. I can only see two projects here because if we recall, project one is not in the assigning status. So I can only see projects two and projects three. So I can select either one of these, click the button to assign tasks, and we see down here in the bottom corner, it's saying started, meaning that it has now performed that automation. You'll also notice that the project was automatically removed from this particular dropdown. Project 2 is no longer available here because it no longer meets the filter of this particular interface page. this page only allows us to see status equals assigned. So let's go ahead and flip into our second interface now. That is the track assigned projects interface. I'm going to select edit first so that we can see the setup here. And here we have a filter condition again on the drop down here. So if we look at that condition, we will see that the status must be in progress or complete. This is why we would never see a project that is not in progress. A project that is assigning or before is never going to show up here. And this way we can make sure that we're only looking at stuff that makes sense in this particular view. Similarly, if we went back to our previous interface, the one that was assigning status, I have a similar filter built here where I have the condition that the status is equal to assigning. So flipping back now into our track assigned projects, here I'm just looking at the status and I'm looking at the tasks and I see which of those are complete and which are not, and I can see how things are progressing with these different projects. Now, if we want to make navigation through our interfaces simpler, rather than having to go into the upper left corner and click and pick the particular page that we want to look at, well, that's another new function of the button. And so we can add an element, again, go to all elements, scroll on down, and let's pick the button here. And we can plug another button in. And now we can drag this button across. Again, let's give it a color of green so that it pops a little bit more. And rather than updating a record, we can change the button type now to go to an interface page. So we can simply set this up and say, hey, rather than making us click multiple times to go through all these different interfaces, let's just go directly to the assigning tasks interface so that when we're looking at our projects here, we can just really quickly flip back and look at those different projects that are in the assigning status. Let's go ahead and publish this and see how it works. Publish these changes. So here I am inside of the published version now of the interface. You'll notice I didn't save the green coloration here, so it is showing up as gray, no problem. Instead of going up in the upper left corner, clicking the menu and finding the interface page that I want to go back to, this simple click is going to take me directly to my assigning interfaces. So here I am only able to see the status of equal assigning. So the only project that meets that is project 3. I can go ahead and assign tasks now to project 3. It's going to trigger my automation, and when it's completed, it'll remove project 3 from this filter. There it is, no longer available because project 3 status no longer meets this filter requirement. Now I can go to my other page here inside of this, and I'm taken to project 3 in status, and it now has this task assigned to it that was built by the automation triggered from that red button. Again, if I want to flip back quickly from my interface without having to navigate all over the place, a simple button click is going to get me back to the previous page that I was just on. I'm pretty excited about these button updates. They really help you navigate a lot more quickly through your interfaces. More importantly, triggering automations is incredibly powerful, and being able to offer that as a trigger inside of your Airtable interface is really kicking things up yet again to the next level. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you did and you don't want to miss future videos about no code and automation, definitely subscribe to this channel, give us a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.